Hello and welcome. Please read the problem, pause the video, and try it on your own. See what you can do. Okay, so here, let's read the problem together. Simplify the following expression in scientific E notation. So we have this expression right here, and by simplifying it, we mean divide what you can. And writing the answer in scientific notation is something we're focusing on here. So we're going to write our number, scientific notation. We think of some number, let's say A, use different color, you probably can't see that, A times the power of 10. And the rule is that the first number, positive or negative, has to be larger than or equal to 1 and less than 10. And the exponent could be any positive or negative whole number. Right? It's very atypical to put integers here for your exponent. E notation, we'll get to at the end, but basically it's the same thing, but instead of writing times 10, we write E. And it means this exact same thing. So here, when we simplify this expression, I notice we're multiplying and multiplying, and then this line in the middle means we're dividing. So we're dividing the entire value in the numerator by the entire value in the denominator. Now, we can manipulate this a little bit to cancel out. We can think of what is 6 divided by 1.5, and we can think what is 10 to the ninth divided by 10 to the negative second. Because we're multiplying in both numerator and denominator, we can kind of pull these values apart and divide them in pieces, and still get the same answer. So 6 divided by 1.5, if we're overwhelmed by that, multiply both by 10. Right? 6.06, in other words, divided by 1.5 is equivalent to 60 over 15. And 15 goes into 60 evenly, it goes into it 4 times. So this quotient, this first part right here, is just 4. Now we divide these two powers of 10, we subtract our exponents, and we have net 9, minus negative 2. 9 minus negative 2 is 11, right? So that's our exponent there. And this could be our answer, except we want to change it to E notation, so it's 4E11. Thanks.